Today we are going to have demo on HTTP, HTTP business and consolidation. So in this particular demo, first we'll take the introduction of the candidate. You can mute yourself using the green microphone on the GoToMeeting panel. So what is analytics? What is EPM? What is BPC? Regarding BPC, what is planning, what is consolidation, all these things we are going to discuss. Then we are going to discuss, we will give you the course details. Yeah, this is the plan. Okay, let's start with introduction. Yeah, Ahmad, can you introduce yourself? You have SAP experience, with that experience or your current experience, and yeah.
Basically, I'm in MBA. I'm working as an FICO consultant here in Saudi Arabia.
Mm-hmm. FICO consultant.
Yeah.
Brigitte.
Hi, it's Bridget.
Yeah, Brigitte. Your experience.
Hi. Yes. I just started learning only the report creation. My actual background is accounting and finance.
Okay. Purna?
Hi, this is Purna, and I am working as an FICO consultant.
So basically, we are taking the demo. Your sessions, regarding your sessions, existing sessions, I will update some. Sumit? Sumit, we cannot hear you. Okay. There is one name called Think. Can you, Think, can you give your introduction? Like, what is your, name?
Hi Kiran, this is Sankarsh. Actually, by mistake, it has by default it's taken the name Thing.
Okay, I got it.
I'm working as a FICO consultant.
Oh, you are also FICO.
Oh, no.
Right.
Okay. Your name?
Sankarsh. C-A-N.
Sankarsh.
Yeah. Right.
Okay, so for most of the
time,
right, so we have most of the consultants with FSC background, which means all people are having a background. So based on this, I will give my I will give quick section of mine. So basically, I started my career FICO, SAP FICO. I worked 3 years in FICO, SAP FICO. Then I moved to I completed certification. I started working in BIIP. BIIP is a integrated planning. It's a planning tool using BW technology. 6 years back, SAP acquired this particular BPC product from Outlook Soft. So after that, I worked in the pre-sales, BPC pre-sales. Then I moved to consulting. I've been working on this BPC. I completed almost 5 business planning and validation projects. Now I'm going to start another project in June. This is my background. I'm a BPC certified, BW certified, and FSCO certified consultant. Now, yeah. So just start. We'll start with what is analytics. Right to that, Sudarshan. Sudarshan.
Unmuted.
Sudarshan.
Hi.
Sudarshan. Yeah. Can you?
Hi.
Can you?
I'm an ABAP developer.
Okay. So, what is analytics? First, we'll discuss as per the schedule. Basically, most of you know, you all know what is ECC system. ECC system is basically OLTP system where you can post your day-to-day transactions. So, this is my ECC system. So when I say ECC, so I'm talking about ERP system, right? So it might be Oracle GL, it might be some other ERP system. So ERP system is storage. You have rows and columns, and your data, whatever invoice data, whatever billing data, whatever sales data is stored in the particular table. If you want some analysis on this data, right? Spontaneous analysis, or you want to show some results with beautiful graphs and all this stuff, you have to write so much code, ABAP code, right? So there is no standard functionality which gives the result as per your requirement, as per the end user requirement. So because it's a row and column based structure, then it is not a multi-dimensional schema structure. And it is for day-to-day transactions. So, to solve all these issues, SAP came up with one thing called analytics. So, analytics basically concentrates on the reporting side, mostly on the actual reporting. So, in this analytics technology, we are going to generate reports, we are going to generate dashboards, we are going to generate some what-if analysis, all these things. Even using this analytics, you can do planning kind of stuff, you can do your disclosure related stuff, you can do your consolidation related stuff, legal consolidation or management consolidation. Using this analytics, you can do the intercompany eliminations, matchings, all this. Based on the product behavior, analytics is having lot of products. Business object related products and BW native products, so many EPM related products. So there are so many products under analytics. Based on the product behavior, based on the product use, SAP divided this analytics into 4 parts. The 4 parts are, first one is EPM. EPM is basically enterprise performance management, then you have GRC, governance and risk control or risk compliance, then you have EIM, enterprise information management, then you have BI, business intelligence. So EPM, BPC is part of EPM. So enterprise performance management we are going to discuss in the next slide. Let's just park it. GRC. GRC is basically the SOX compliance or environment health and safety, and other risk analysis can be done using this GRC products. Then EIM, enterprise information management. If you want to transfer data from your legacy system to your current system, yes, you can use EIM products. Like you might have had like BODS, business object data services. So BODS is part of EIM. So when you are transferring data from one system to another system, you can check the quality, you can remove the duplicate, right? So all these things. And so basically EIM products basically transfer data from one legacy system to target system or one system to another system. Then you have business intelligence. Business intelligence is basically most of the reporting tools are part of business intelligence. So you know business object. Business object is having Webby to prepare the report, Crystal, SAP Lumira, SAP Predictive Analytics, a Dashboard Designer. All these are part of business intelligence. So every product has its own use. Like Predictive Analytics, you can predict based on the statistical method. Dashboard Designer, you can create dashboards using what if analysis, or you can create interactive dashboards and which can give you the future, what if kind of condition. And you have Query Designer, you have Web Application Designer, part of BW, using this, you can prepare so many into current customer requirements. So all these are part of analytics. We are going to talk about EPM, Enterprise Performance Management. So, Enterprise Performance Management. So, Enterprise Performance Management is basically part of analytics. EPM is part of analytics. Under EPM, you have so many products. So all planning and consolidation related products are part of this particular EPM. Let's say BPC MS, Microsoft version, is part of EPM. BPC NetWeaver is part of BOFC, Business Object Financial Consolidation. Business Object Financial Consolidation. This was called as Cartesis in the prior religious. And you have SSM, SAP Strategy Management. You have PCM, Profitability and Cost Management. You have Disclosure Management, which can you can generate reports, legal compliance reports using Disclosure Management, IFRS reports, or US GAAP reports, or Indian GAAP reports using Disclosure Management. And yes, there are some other products, and FIM, Financial Information Management, which is a ETL tool. So there are some other products like intercompany matching and supply chain management related products, all this. Now let's talk about BPC first. BPC, SAP acquired BPC in 2000.
Right, Kiran, can we have the questions now or after this session?
Yeah, you can stop me at any time, not a problem.
fine. See, you're saying that in EPM we have got these different products. So when we talk about BPC, it's planning and consolidation. And again, we have here this financial consolidation. Are they both the same product or different?
Okay, good question. BPC consolidation, BYFC consolidation, the objective is legal consolidation. Right? Both does legal consolidation. So both the products can do currency translation, both the products can do consolidation of investments, both the products can do intercompany eliminations, intercompany matching, both the products can have controls. Now the question is then why two products? So basically, if you see one more, for consolidation, one more product also there called BCS, business consolidation. Even in ECC system, you have consolidation, right? So basically, it's a flexibility. If you use BPC, the configuration is different. If you use BYFC, the configuration is different. If you see, for me, it is the client decision which product they want to take. Using BPC or BYFC, both the things, I can do my consolidation. Earlier, the particular consultant used to say, what is the difference between BPC and BYFC? Then they used to say, BYFC can handle lots of data and the performance is good. But now, that particular issue is resolved because BPC NetWeaver on HANA can work on big data and the performance is better than BYFC. So it is client decision. The sales team, the pre-sales team, how they decide, they get to know which product they have to sell. So based on that, they will sell and the client will purchase. There is no pros and cons. There is no analysis on this. And some advantages, if you take BPC, you can do the planning and consolidation both. BYFC, you can do only consolidation. Yeah? No.
Okay, fine. You mean basically it's a matter of licensing what the client wants to have?
Yes.
Okay, okay.
Now, so in BPC there are two versions, BPC MS and BPC NetWeaver. We are going to learn both BPC MS and BPC NetWeaver. So SQL Server is the backend for this BPC MS. BW on HANA or BW NetWeaver, sorry, BPC NetWeaver or BPC NetWeaver on HANA, the backend is BW, business backend. Right? Don't think BPC NetWeaver on HANA, HANA is the database. No. BW is the database and BW will be on HANA. This I will explain later. Now BYFC, right? So BYFC is consolidation product. It's also, it sits on Oracle or some other database. Every product is having its own database now, right? Now you have to understand what is FIM. FIM is Financial Information Management. It's kind of ETL tool, extraction, transformation, and loading tool. So suppose I am using BPC MS, okay? I need to load data. Because BPC MS is a standalone system. It is not integrated with any BW or ECC system. So how the actual data loaded? You can use FIM, Financial Information tool. You can load data from ECC, from BW, from other non-SAP systems to FIM system. From FIM, you can load it to BPC MS. So BPC, FIM is like BW, which extracts the data, which transforms the data, and which loads the data to the target system. Now, what is BPC? BPC is basically business planning and consolidation, all know. Using this BPC, you can do your financial planning, Financial planning in the sense your P&L statement planning, your balance sheet planning, your cash flow planning, yeah, your material cost planning, your sales planning, your revenue planning, your expense planning, all these are part of financial planning. So basically we can do the revenue planning in the sense what is my sales unit, what is the value of the price of the sales unit and how much I am going to sell. So for this particular region, how much I can sell, for this particular location, how much I can sell, for this particular company code in the local currency, how much I can sell, what is the converted value. If you have any assumptions, based on the assumptions you can calculate your revenue. All these things can be handled by revenue planning. Then you have expense planning, or mostly we call it as operational expense planning. Operational expenses planning, basically you do for your, suppose you want to plan your manpower cost, you want to plan your how much your rent, how much your convenience, how much you are going to pay as an interest. All these things you can calculate using operational expense planning. So operation, and you can do the headcount planning. So how many people are working for each location, each department. So how many people you are going to recruit in the next year. How many people going to retire in this particular year. How many people are going to get promotion in the next year. All these things you can handle using headcount planning. Then you can do capital expenditure planning, CapEx planning. CapEx planning is basically what are your future projects. So next 10 years, what is your plan of your investment? Are you going to start some projects, like I want to start some plan so that I can increase my production, so that I can increase my sales. So if I want to increase my sales, I have to increase my production. If I want to increase my production, I need to increase my manpower and I have to do some technical work. All these things can be planned using capital expenditure planning. Then you can do the P&L statement planning, PL statement. Then you can do the balance sheet planning. Then you can do the cash flow planning. What is the cash flow, inflow, outflow? All these things can be done using financial planning. The next thing is you can do the legal consolidation. So it is consolidation part. Using this legal consolidation, I can close my books. So period end closing can be executed. So part of period end closing, like balance carry forward, which is BCF, and you can post some journals if any differences or any adjustment entry, right? Then you can do the account reclassification. Account reclassification in the sense, suppose if you want to prepare cash flow, okay, that calculations can be done using account reclassification concept. If you want to calculate net income, and if you want to transfer this particular net income to retained earnings, yes, you can do using account reclassification. Then currency translation. All your local currencies can be translated and stored against the target currency. Then you can do the consolidation of investment. Consolidation of investment based on your investment structure, consolidation structure based on your holding and subsidiary relationship. using particular consolidation method like purchase proportionate or equity method. You can consolidate your investments at the group level. So you can track your purchase methods, you can track your consolidation percentages, you can track your consolidation structure. Like today I have one consolidation structure, next month some companies are moving or leaving, okay, from one place to another place, or new or existing, okay, you can handle with this consolidation of investment. Then you have intercompany matching or intercompany eliminations. So as part of consolidation of investment, you can execute this intercompany elimination. Using this intercompany elimination, you can eliminate the intercompany transactions within the group. Now intercompany matching. So using this intercompany matching concept, you can match your books, C1000 books, one company code books with another company code within the group. If any differences are there in the intercompany transactions, you can book those differences using this intercompany matching functionality. And not only legal consolidation, you can do one more consolidation called management consolidation. Management consolidation is basically for internal consolidation, okay, it's also called as internal consolidation. So using this internal consolidation, I can prepare my consolidation reports based on my profit centers or segments or product line, whatever level. So here in the management consolidation, we don't need a consolidation of investments or closing process or whatever. So here we do US elimination. Only US eliminations means it's a name they have given. So using US eliminations, you can do the inter unit elimination, you can say. That may be profit center, that may be segment, that may be other dimension. So you can do the inter unit eliminations using US elimination functionality. So management consolidation basically for the internal purpose. For the consolidation, SAP added some new functionalities in the BPC 10, like consolidation central. As part of consolidation central, you have consolidation monitor. Using this consolidation monitor, you can monitor your statuses of your consolidation process, like who are all completed, who are all not completed, right? Whether currency translation is run for all the groups or not, whether consolidation is run for all the groups or not, whether after the consolidation this particular data is locked or not, all these things you can control using consolidation monitor. You have ownership manager. There is a tool. Using this ownership manager, you can maintain your consolidation structure, your group structure, you can define your parent-child relationship. And you have some functionalities called business process flows, which is used for planning and consolidation both, which is a workflow. We are going to workflows, and we are going to discuss aspects like how the data is loaded from BW to BPC, how the data is transferred from BPC to dashboard designer, how you can reconcile your data, BPC data, with your ECC and BW system. All these things we are going to cover in this particular course. So as per our, we had the introduction, we discussed what is analytics. Analytics is basically for the reporting. Analytics again divided into four parts: EPM, GRC, and EAM and BI. So we are BPC comes under EPM, Enterprise Performance Management. This EPM is having so many products like the BPC MS, BPC NetWeaver, BOFC, SSM, SAP Strategy Management, BCM Profitability and Cost Management. Basically, BYFC is consolidation, and SSM, SAP Strategy Management, is basically your for your performance measurement. Suppose you have some goals, whether you have achieved that goals or not. Suppose my company is having some strategy to reach, to achieve, I mean, to accomplish that strategy, I should have some perspectives, I should have some individual KPIs, key performance indicators. All these things can be handled using SSM. PCM, so it is kind of ABC analysis, activity-based costing. So based on that, you can understand what are the costs involved, what are the drivers for those costs, how my profitability can be changed based on some combinations. So BPC is part of EPM, okay, business planning and consolidation. Using this BPC, you can do the planning and consolidation, both the things. So next, the course details. Basically, I'm going to cover.
Kiran, sorry to interrupt you. One question again.
Yeah.
In the previous slide, you were saying about about HANA. Can you just brief about that? Like, what is the difference? Like, if you say with HANA or without that?
Yeah. See, basically, let's say this is my ECC system. On top of ECC system, I have BW system. On top of BW system, I have PPC. Now, basically, the flow like this, data flow is like this. From ECC, actual data is loaded to BW. From BW, you can load data to BPC. Right? So, in BPC, actual and planned data can be handled. This scenario is for BPC NetWeaver. When I say BPC NetWeaver, this is the scenario. Now, what is the database for BW? BW database is basically Oracle or DB. Oracle. Let's say I am using Oracle as BW database. BPC database is BW. Okay. This is BPC NetWeaver technical architecture. Now, I want this one for BPC NetWeaver on HANA. So the database will be here, everything is same, everything is same, the database will be fine. Whatever you are doing here, the same thing you are, but not directly related to this HANA, right? So using this HANA, you have some advantages, that advantages we are going to do. What are the advantages you are going to have? That is the difference between BPC NetWeaver and BPC NetWeaver and HANA. So in this course, when I say BPC NetWeaver on HANA, we are not going to discuss anything on HANA. So what is parallel processing, what is HANA, how the hardware should be configured, how the system should be analyzed, all these things we are not going to do. Yeah. So now the course details. The course details, we are going to have this BPC NetWeaver session. My sessions are based on the certification course C_EPM BPC_10. This is the latest certification available. So after my course, you can easily write the certification. So the required books for this BPC certification is BPC 410, which is discuss BPC MS, 420, which discusses the BPC NetWeaver planning, 430, which discusses EPM add-in, which is required for MS and BPC MS and BPC NetWeaver, and BPC 440, which discusses consolidation. So we are going to cover all these four books. I can provide you some certification questions, interview questions. Now, total 35 hour session. In this every day we will take one hour to 1.5 hours, right? A weekday session. Weekday session, when I say weekday session, for US, this is Monday to Friday. Monday to Friday, the time is 9 p.m. EST. For India, this is Tuesday to Saturday, 6:30 a.m. IST. The same time, US 9 p.m. is 6:30 a.m. in India. Right? So, yeah. These are the course details. Any questions now? Tomorrow.
Is it like the daily sessions, or like, you know, we can? Is there an option to have like, you know, like on the 3 sessions a week, or like you know, something like that?
Come again?
No, I mean your sessions will be continuously for the weekdays from Tuesday to Saturday, or you have any other timings on which you conduct both, like on different times, like alternate day or?
No, basically the problem is I am also working, so I will get only 1.5 hour time each day, so that I will spend on particular course. There is no alternative timing. Only this timing, every day we'll have 1 hour or 1 hour plus. Weekends, no special. So tomorrow we'll have session with the same time and same meeting request. Yeah, the meeting request, I'm not changing the meeting request. Even I have given the schedule in the mail. So from tomorrow we'll continue with the same meeting request. Yeah.
Kiran, I have a question.
Yep.
During this course, do I get any hands-on, like project-related work, or how is it going to be, the hands-on experience on HANA?
On HANA or on BPC?
BPC with HANA.
Okay. Background.
See?
Like.
Actually, purely from Java background.
Java background.
Yeah.
So, there are two guys like Sudarshan and you. Okay. BPC should have a financial. Okay. Let me complete this one. For the FSU work consultant, yes, they can easily understand because they have financial background. For you, Sudarshan and Pratiban, you don't have FSU or finance background. So how to handle now? So for you, what I will do, I have prepared one PowerPoint presentation, okay, PPT,
okay,
for accounting, IFRS accounting,
okay.
There's an IFRS. How to do the accounting principles, all this. How to debit one transaction, how to credit transaction, what is trial balance, what is cash flow, what is P&L statement, what is cash flow, all these things. Okay, I prepared.
Okay.
I have books. See, accounting, if you Google, you can get hundreds of books. Those are 800 pages, 900 pages, and consultants like us can't go through all these pages. I can understand. Mm-hmm. Way to solve this issue, I came up with a PowerPoint presentation of 59 slides, and it explains whatever terminology, whatever concept required for this planning.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever to handle BPC planning project, whatever terminology, whatever accounting knowledge you need, that will be covered. Okay.
Okay. Sure. Great.
So after this course, you will be a functional consultant. So, I will not, as I said, I will not discuss on HANA, whatever.
Okay.
Technical,
okay.
Not going to discuss anything. I'm just talking about BPC. And you will get 100% hands-on. That is for sure. I will make it in system and I will show you system. Give it both.
Okay. Okay. Part of this course, we are not touching HANA, right?
No, no. Yes.
Okay. And this exam also like purely for BPC?
Yes. It is BPC. BPC NetWeaver and HANA. Okay. BPC NetWeaver, this is the certificate course.
Okay. Okay. Great. Okay. Okay. I'm clear. Yeah. Thanks, Kiran.
Yeah. So let me show you the PowerPoint presentation. I just checked whether it is there or not. So just I will show you the PowerPoint presentation.
Mm-hmm.
Be online. Somewhere I kept. Yeah, meanwhile, any other questions from other participants?
Yeah, Kiran, we were talking about planning. You said that we can do the financial planning with the BPC. So, like, you know, organizations talk about the sales planning, the production planning, and all these things. All that kind of planning, can we do handle this in BPC?
Very good question. All the planning can be handled using BPC NetWeaver. Yes, you can handle all the, let's say, production planning. Yes, you can handle, not an issue. There are some workarounds, right? BPC is basically account-based product. Account-based product means it is very good for financial planning. So it is not good for the key figure-based planning. But using some workarounds, you can do this production planning in BPC. But one more thing here I have to tell you. SAP is going to release version called BPC 10.1. This BPC 10.1 is having two things. One is classic, another one is unified. In the classic means whatever we are going to discuss. This is called classic, right? I mean, the unified models mainly designed for whatever scenarios you are asking, production planning, demand planning or supply planning, whatever. For that, this unified planning is designed. So using unified planning, do whatever planning you want, even financial planning and other key figure based planning, account based planning and key figure based planning. So this technology, unified technology is based on BIIP. Okay, once SAP releases this unified, then I will start the training on this unified model. Yeah.
Wait, Kiran, what is this BIIP stand for?
Business Intelligence Integrated Planning. Integrated planning. Both are, before BPC, we used to have one planning tool called BIIP and another planning tool is BPS, Business Planning Simulator. Both are part of BW. So this is the fundamentals of financial accounting presentation I have. Yeah. Give me 1 second. What extent? I need BW knowledge for this BPC course. There are students who knows BW, then learns BPC. Okay, and if you see here, most of the consultants are not having BW knowledge, right? So all are background with FSQ, right? So whatever BW knowledge required for this consultant, right? I'm going to give like this particular consultant should understand what is InfoObject, what is InfoCube, how to display data from InfoCube, how to display data from InfoObject, how to load data from BW to BPC. Yes, I'm going to discuss. I'm going to explain. I'm going to show it in the system so you can practice. I'm not going to cover. What I'm not going to cover in this particular session is basically how to load data from ECC to BW. That is BW consultant work. That is not BPC consultant work. So ECC to BW, not part of the course. BW to BPC is part of the course. Loading part of the course. So I have muted some of mother. Brigitte, do you have any questions? Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell me, Sangharsh.
Regarding the application which we are using and the test data, all these things. Because we have to practice post your sessions, right?
Yeah, I got you. You can 100% I mean 100% you can practice basically. 100% thing, I mean whatever I am teaching, everything you can practice. For that, whatever transaction data required, whatever master data required, whatever configuration is required. I mean, basically, ECC you can do year-wise closing, right? Yearly month closing. Suppose retained earnings are calculated yearly once, right? But legal consolidation, suppose I want to do every month, I can do that, period end closing, using BCF for example. Okay. Every month or quarter.
Okay. And as part of this course, you want to cover all the topics you specified in this slide, right?
Yeah. I can send you the course content. Just send an email to my mail ID. Yes, all these things we are going to cover. Whatever I mentioned here, everything we are going to cover. If you take
So what is the
planning areas will be explained. I will not go through like what is revenue planning, what is operational expense plan, what is export planning. No. I just give you based on BPC 420, right? How to configure planning scenarios using that configuration. You can configure any planning scenario. Consolidation, I will cover whatever I mentioned here.
Okay.
Finally, I'm going to take example like revenue planning. One scenario I'm going to explain. It is difficult to explain all the scenarios. Yeah.
Okay. Also, on the you know, what is the advantage? Like, do you, your experience, once a financial FICO consultant or anyone who has SAP knowledge goes into BPC, so you know, what can be the advantage in doing that? Is there a hike in billing rate or hike in project related position? What is the advantage there?
Okay, very good question. See, basically, when you do the benefit analysis, right, the things, if you have FICO background, okay, three types of consultants you have. BPC, solution architect, so even we call it as subject matter expert. BPC, application consultant. And BPC developer or BPC technical consultant, okay, BPC developer, let's say, most understandable company, BPC developer. BPC solution architect, right, should have finance background, right, he should have FICO background or BW background, it is must, because when you are giving the solution, you have to analyze their FICO system, BW system, that you have to give the solution in BPC. BPC application consultant should know BPC perfectly. Right? If he knows some of the BW, that will be added advantage. Like how to, what is the terminology and how to view the data. BPC developer should know BPC and ADA. So, according to market, let's say like the competition is very low for BPC, and the price, okay, anyways, the PPC consultant will get more price than this FSCO consultant. That is for, that is 100%. Yeah. Any other questions from other participants? Okay then. Thank you.